ready, start. The president has said that in the last 60 years we have progressed along this path illuminated by Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru. We shall adhere to it, come what may, with the determination and courage instilled in us by Sonia Gandhi. In my opinion, this is the time for all of us, whether belonging to that side or this side, irrespective of party affiliations, to rededicate ourselves to these basic fundamentals of our constitution. If we do that, we will be a united India. Not only will we command respect in the committee of nations, but the foundations will be such that nobody on the earth will be able to do any harm to us. I have one thing to say, that our country is a continent, and in this continent we have faced this year one of the severest droughts in 100 years. It is the prudent policy of having accumulated buffer stocks that, in spite of setbacks that we have experienced, there has not been any starvation death. This is a tribute to the ingenuity of our policy of having created the buffer stocks. To my mind, there are one or two grey areas. One of the grey areas is our population explosion, which my friend Sri Prashant has also referred to. We may be doing what we are doing. For instance, 20 million acceptors of contraceptives and other things we have produced, but we have not evolved a national consensus on this issue. I spoke about the matter in different forums when the Prime Minister was also there. I told him that a national consensus on family welfare program must be evolved. I also told him that you have been calling meetings of the opposition parties quite often on different issues, but to my mind, the most important issue for which an All India party meeting should be convened is to evolve a national policy on population. In spite of our all-round economic development, it all gets nullified by the population explosion. We have not done much in this direction. I had the privilege of going to China, and I saw how they are progressing in this regard. It is true that there have been many occasions when undue advantage has been taken by one party or the other in the implementation of this program. That is why I want national consensus on family planning. Sir, I go to the next area, and that is with regard to agriculture. The agriculture minister has stated in a conference the other day that in spite of drought, he has fixed a target of 175 million tons of food grains for the current year. That is a good idea, but the important thing to which the president has referred is the need of increase in the production of oil seeds, and to this I add pulses. I want the government to give special attention to the production of these things, because edible oils and pulses are the common man's need in India, and we are having shortage of pulses and edible oils, and we are importing these in a very large quantity. So the thrust of our program, as we have done in the case of Green Revolution, is that we should concentrate on the production of pulses and edible oils, and then assure our own people that within a period of 2 years we will attain self-sufficiency in edible oils and pulses. The next point is with regard to public sector. There is no doubt that the public sector occupies a commanding height, and it has occupied commanding heights in our mixed economy. But the problem of accountability of public sector has not been done to the desired extent. I submit, sir, that for this purpose, the program implementation ministry is helping the public sector undertakings with regard to any difficulties that they face in that ministry. On or before 5th of every month, they get a report from the particular undertaking with regard to the difficulties that they face in manufacturing or marketing or finance or any other thing, and the program implementation ministry sees to it that these difficulties are removed. But a new thinking has come to the heads of these public sector undertakings, that is by sending the report on the 5th of every month. They pass on the buck to the program implementation ministry, and they forget about what they have written. This attitude has to be changed. The executives of these public undertakings should be told that the planning commission or the program implementation ministry is there only to help you, and it is for you to set things right and see that any difficulties faced by them are removed and their undertaking shows results. I think for that purpose it will be advisable that their promotion or renewal of their contract or enhancement of their present grade should be linked with the jobs done by the heads of these public sector undertakings stopped.